Life comes from the soil. Everything around us, it brings us back. The best steward of the soil is really the people living on it. Almost everything we're wearing is colored with chemicals that sometimes are dumped directly in the river. And it is not us that face this problem. It's actually the communities living around the river that has to face it. Oh, yeah, yeah. And that was really when we start tracing our steps back to find the older generation who still remember how their ancestors used to use all these plants to create all these amazing colors. The way we're currently doing our conventional agriculture is degrading the soil in such a way that we're left with only 60 years of harvest cycles. But running this project made me realize that there's a different way, that it is possible to make things in a way that actively restores life back to the soil. They can learn from the last generation of Indonesian cotton farmers to grow cotton the way their ancestors used to do it, and grow 20 different crops together, because each has its own function. And because we're growing it that way, we don't need to use any chemicals. This is the way nature grows things. And when you have diversity, you have resilience. Because now, she's not just relying on just one crop. That means she always has something to earn a livelihood from.
Mbok kasih senenge jaya. Rasa nganggo kemiah. Saiki jembletek kapasi. Saiki ku yo penak yo petuk mangan sing marai aku seneng be lemah padha wae ambe nyenengi awakku dhewe.
In Ibu Kasmini's farm, within 2 years, her yield increased 6 times. These practices are so universal. You can apply it anywhere around the world. This is how we adapt to the changing climate, by following this natural rhythm of the earth.